Hey guys, welcome back. A new software update is rolling out for OnePlus 5 and 5T users. But that's for beta channel. For OnePlus 5, it's Open Beta 31, and for OnePlus 5T, it is Open Beta 29. So right now I'm running stable version on my OnePlus 5, which is Oxygen OS 9.0.5. If you guys haven't checked that video, the link will be given in the description below or the I button. People who are running beta version, they should receive an OTA update, but as I'm running stable version, so I had to do a local upgrade of it. So what you have to do is you can download the file from the description below and place it inside the internal storage. Once you have done with that, you need to go to settings, system update, tap on the gear icon towards the right top corner, select local upgrade and choose the file. Device will take around 3 to 4 minutes to complete the entire process. So as you can see, device have been successfully updated and we have updated from stable version to beta version, which did not affect my data available on the device. So as soon as you update your device, you'll get this OnePlus privacy policy update. Now let me show you the software information by going to settings, about phone, and here you can see Oxygen OS version is Open Beta 31. This is my OnePlus 5. Under Android version is 9. Security patch is 1st April 2019 and the build date is 28th April. With this latest update, launcher has been upgraded to version 3.4, which is the latest one and still not available on OnePlus 6 or 6T. This is your shelf where you can manage the cards, which also includes parking location feature, which was previously added on open beta versions. And the camera version has also been updated to version 3.0.37, which does not include any kind of new features. Now let's take a look at the change logs. So as I've done a local upgrade, change logs won't show me in the system update section. So I've taken a screenshot from OnePlus forum and these are the change logs which are related to system, quick reply and community app. First one under system, it says display overheating device warning. So I also tried to heat up the device. As you can see, the device temperature went up to 43.3 degrees Celsius, but there were no warnings. But this is a nice feature what they have added in terms of safety. So people who play lots of games and their device gets heated up, they will get a warning message on the screen. After that, new UI for system update. So let me show you that also. Going to settings, system, and under system you can see we have a new UI for the system update. Wherein still you can use the other features like local upgrade and view update features. The next change log is related to quick reply, which says supported more instant messaging app for quick reply in landscape mode. So here they have just added few more applications for quick reply in landscape. So if you guys are not aware about quick reply in landscape, that can be found inside utilities. And here you have the option of quick reply in the landscape. You can enable that from here. And here you have a short animation to show how does it work. And under quick reply, it says app doesn't get paused while using quick reply in landscape. So this I had never faced any kind of issues related to app pause. After that, moving on to the next change log, which is related to community app, which says optimize search experience by adding search field and group search results in different categories. So let's go and check community app. And here this is a new community app, which also brings a new initial setup. Now they have added the search option at the top of the community app on the main homepage. Later they have optimized the UI of social page. So here few optimizations have been done under this social page. After that, last one under community app is optimize log recording in bug report section. So here also they have done few optimizations related to bug report. And if you guys are not aware how to report bugs, then you can just tap this plus icon, go to feedback. And from here, you can report any bugs, whatever you are facing on your device. If it's related to system, phone network, OnePlus app, third party, UI and settings, and security. So guys, these are the complete change logs of latest open beta for OnePlus 5 and 5T. You guys also let me know about the size of the update if you're already on previous beta. And if anyone getting overheating warning on the device while using the device for a longer time, then do share a screenshot on a Telegram group. So now let's take a look at the benchmark results. With Geekbench application, single core have scored 1895, wherein multi-core have scored 6123. With Antutu benchmark application, device have scored 151,962, and the scores are pretty low comparing to stable version of Oxygen OS. So guys, this was all about the latest update for OnePlus 5 and 5T. If you have any kind of questions, you can let me know in the comment section below. As of now, only this much in this video. Hope you like the video, and if you like the video, then do give me a thumbs up. Also, if you are new to my channel, then do not forget to subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.